Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel for a short video about the little swirl you can see on most jet turbine engines. Now, once they spin, they look pretty cool, but do they have a specific purpose? And you'll be surprised how many different shapes and sizes are out there. So, let's get spinning.
1383, runway 27, clear takeoff.
Now let's imagine you're sitting in a terminal, gazing out of the window, and the incoming aircraft is taxiing towards the gate position. I'm sure you've spotted these before, which look like one of those spinning things fortune tellers use to mesmerize their clients. Obviously, that's not their purpose, and alongside the fact that they don't have an industrial name. So let's call them spinner spirals for today's video. Now the spinner itself is an aerodynamically shaped cone or dome in the center of the fan covering the fan blade mounts. Many engine manufacturers like Pratt & Whitney, General Electric, CFM and Rolls-Royce have been painting spinners with the catchy swirls for decades. The practice even goes back as far as World War II when the spirals were painted on the propeller cones. So the primary reason for painting designs on engine spinners is for safety of the ground personnel. Now working near a running jet engine is extremely dangerous, and for example a Boeing 737 engine running at idle power has a hazard zone of 9 feet to the front and the sides of the engine. Now this means that even at idle thrust, a human that walks within the hazard area or any loose objects risk being sucked up into the engine. And when the engine is above idle thrust, the hazard zone increases to 14 feet or more. Now, not to speak of even larger hazardous zones of a Boeing 777, for example. Therefore, it's absolutely critical that the ground personnel can identify a running engine and stay away from it. Even though jet engines are incredibly loud, a running engine may not be obvious to ground personnel. Airport aprons often have several airplanes in close proximity with engines screaming next to each other. Therefore, ground personnel have to wear hearing protection to suppress the deafening noise. And making matters worse, it can be hard to see that the engine is running, especially during nighttime operation, as the black and grey fan blades become translucent when they're spinning. Therefore, spinning spirals make it a lot easier to identify a running engine. And besides that, ground personnel can check if the airplane's red anti-collision light is still flashing. This indicates that the pilots have received a startup clearance and will start the engines very soon. And on arrival at the gate, the light is turned off by the pilots after the engines are shut off and spiraled down, after which it is safe to approach the engines from either side. For the same safety reason, the tips of propeller blades on propeller-driven airplanes like the Dash Q400 are painted in bright colors to be more visible to the human eye. And you won't believe how many incidents have happened in the past involving jet engines and ground personnel. Do the spirals scare away birds? Now, that's a difficult question to answer, and many rumors have arisen around this question. Birds and aircraft engines are a bad combination. Bird ingestion and bird impact cause expensive damage to the engines, and the birds aren't happy about it either. For years, it's been speculated that spinner spirals might startle or frighten birds away from the engine during taxi, takeoff and landing. Doing the research on this topic, I found numerous explanations that made sense in my opinion. However, I'm not an ornithologist, but birds have the tendency to seek shelter in holes and caves. A spinning turbine imitates a black hole, so birds may be more likely to fly towards them. Therefore, the flickering image of the spiral startles the birds to fly near the engine inlet. Japan's All Nippon Airways, ANA, for example, completed a year-long study in 1986. The airline patented wobbly ball-styled eyes on the engine spinners of some of the aircraft. The airline found a small reduction in bird impacts on those airplanes, so ANA added the markings to the rest of their fleet. If you consider the cost of a $40 spinner paint job compared to a $10 million engine replacement, you would have all the spinners painted if you thought it would be even only a minor reduction in bird strikes. This has then led to many different shapes and styles that engineers and airlines have tested on their planes. Here, for example, you see the apostrophe on the Boeing 747-400 by Cathay Pacific. The most common one, the g-swirl on a Boeing 777 by Emirates, the longer spiral on a Singapore Boeing 777, the typhoon or hurricane on a Philippine Airlines Airbus A330, and a few more which were really hard to find, the horseshoe, the wobbly crescent, and the comma. I personally think they look cool and I like them for their safety benefit for the ground personnel, as their job is dangerous enough. I can't really say if they straddle birds or not. I've experienced numerous bird strikes with spinner spirals when without. I personally think the most effective way to scare birds are with the landing lights or by the airport ranger who fires a shotgun every now and then to scare the birds. I'm not kidding, they really do that. And one more thing, there's a bit of a legend that the Germans used their massive spinner spirals on the Messerschmitt fighter plane to confuse or distract Allied gunners. I doubt that because at high RPM, the markings are more of a blur than an optical illusion. Lighting conditions and the viewing angle would have had to been perfect for the enemy gunner to see and be confused by the spinner markings. The purpose for the markings in World War II was the same as it's now, safety for ground personnel. That's it for today. Thanks very much for your time. I hope you enjoyed this video and don't forget, a good pilot is always learning. See you next week. All the best, your Captain Joe.